The South Dakota Showdown Series returns to the gridiron tomorrow afternoon. 2 o'clock is the kickoff as the second-ranked team in the FCS, 4-1 South Dakota State, hosts 1-3 South Dakota. Hi, friends. Tyler Merriam, and welcome to Game Day Eve. We'll break down the matchup in just a moment. First up, if you have not done so yet, subscribe to our Jackrabbit Sports Network podcast. Hours of content each week, an extended interview with Director of Athletics Justin Sell each and every Saturday, game replays, and much more. So subscribe to the Jackrabbit Sports Network wherever you podcast. The SDSU football team dominant over Western Illinois, 34-10 last Saturday, the final. The Jackrabbits held the ball for 41 minutes and 26 seconds, the second longest time of possession in SDSU's favor in the Division I era. Isaiah Davis, the Missouri Valley Football Conference Offensive Player of the Week, he carried 27 times for 199 yards and his first two rushing touchdowns of the season, if you can believe that. Did it behind those 605 Hogs, the excellent offensive line, one of them the All-American Mason McCormick, named the Missouri Valley Football Conference's Offensive Lineman of the Week. Reese Winkleman recorded a sack. He is now ninth in school history, 17 sacks in his career, while the All-American defensive tackle Caleb Sanders, with yet another tackle for loss, 35 during his time in yellow and blue. He's tied for fifth in school history. And Jackson Yonke had a terrific day, made 9 catches for 94 yards. He is now 7th in career receptions with 155, and his 18 career receiving touchdowns are 8th in school history. Few other notes on the yellow and blue. The Jackrabbit defense, how good has it been so far? 5th best in the nation overall, 3rd against the run, holding teams to barely 2 yards per rush. They will be tested by that Coyote rushing attack tomorrow. Jacks are plus 6 in turnover margin. That's top 10 in the FCS. We talked about Davis. He is tied for the Missouri Valley Football Conference lead in total rushing yards. And Adam Box, 43 tackles, currently sits 2nd in the Valley. The opposition tomorrow afternoon, the University of South Dakota. The Coyotes are 1-3, but in tremendous fairness, look at the schedule USD has played. Its opponents on the road against a top 20 FBS program in Kansas State, on the road at number 3 Montana, at home to number 1 North Dakota State 2 weeks ago, and now they come here tomorrow to face number 2 SDSU, so they have been through a lot. They also had a change as far as the play calling is concerned. Veteran head coach Bob Nielsen made that adjustment 3 weeks ago. He has called plays the last 2 games. He hadn't done that since the Division II days over a decade ago. But Nielsen, an excellent head coach, 3-time National Coach of the Year in Division II. Twice, he has won national championships. This Coyote team a year ago racked up 340 yards per game. This year, 15 yards fewer, not that big of a dip, but they're scoring 11 points per game less. Now, a lot of that, again, likely because of the competition they have faced. They have a veteran offensive line, and they've been battling some injuries, but with that bye week last week, sounds like they're all healthy. This may be the first time this season the Coyotes have all 5 of their offensive linemen that they expected to have at the beginning of the year. That line is anchored by number 70, Alex Jensen, the All-American at left tackle. The O-line averages 6'6", 315 pounds. Quarterback Carson Camp tomorrow should become the 8th Coyote in program history to achieve 4,000 passing yards. He'll make his 21st consecutive start. He's been running the ball more in addition to his throwing abilities. He had a 75-yard touchdown scamper against Cal Poly a couple of weeks back, and he had 13 rushing attempts against North Dakota State. 2 running backs, both are very good for the Coyotes. Number 5, Travis Tice, was honorable mention All-Valley a year ago. He's just a brick, a tough guy to bring down on the run. 297 rushing yards through 4 games. On top of that, he has a team-high 12 receptions. If it's not Tice, number 1, Shamari Lawrence, who has a little more wiggle to him. He had a 30-yard run against North Dakota State, and he gave Kansas State fits in the opener. Wildcats couldn't bring him down. He had 14 carries for 84 yards. Two wide receivers to keep an eye on. Number 14, Carter Bell, led the team a year ago with 41 receptions en route to honorable mention All-Valley status. Only has four catches this year. They just haven't been able to get him the football, but he's very dangerous. Number 9, Wesley Elidore, honorable mention All-Valley a year ago. Also, 9 catches for 175 yards in each of the last two games. He secured a touchdown pass. At tight end, Austin Gearing has been hurt, so J.J. Galbraith, who wears number 82, has stepped up. Second on the team in receptions with 11, so he is a threat in that passing game. We shift to the defensive side of the ball for USD. Coyotes are giving up 28 points, right about 450 yards per game, including 239 on the ground. That's the most in the Missouri Valley. Their linebacking core is the strength of their defense. The two guys in the middle to keep an eye on, 49 Brock Mogensen, a preseason All-American. He had a career-high 15 tackles against North Dakota State 2 weeks ago in Vermilion. He is sixth in the league in tackles. He's second on the team to 34 Stephen Hillis. An injury forced him into the lineup. The sixth-year junior leads the Coyotes with 39 stops. Cornerback Miles Harden wears number 1. He is excellent out there on the island. Might be the best corner the Jacks have seen this year. And Harden is a turnover-forcing machine. How much has he been able to do that? 7 turnovers forced in 4 games. Harden has come up with 3 interceptions and 4 forced fumbles. He is a 3-year starter. Number 2, Dennis Shorter at safety, will stick his nose in the run game. He is a big hitter in that secondary. He had 10 tackles and a forced fumble against North Dakota State, but he can also be a factor in the passing game. He leads the Coyotes with 4 passes broken up. As far as the front line of USD, so far the best might be the D-tackle Blake Holden, the Watertown native who wears number 61, had a career day with 5 stops against the Bison. Let's talk about special teams. Eddie Ogamba has a very big leg. He's only tried 4 field goals. He's missed his 2 furthest attempts where he's hit from a couple right around 20 yards, but 11 of his 14 kickoffs have gone for touchbacks. Again, a very big leg on the tall veteran. And John Bickle, the punter, a transfer from Wheaton, a Division III school. 10 of his 26 punts have landed inside the 20 for an average of 41. In the return game, Carter Bell, Wesley Elidore, those two wideouts we talked about. Bell had a punt return for a score in Fargo against North Dakota State last fall, while Elidore had a kickoff return that he ran back 99 yards at Missouri State. So they are dangerous both when returning punts and kicks. USD is 1-3. Do not let that record fool you. This is a very good team coming into Dana J. Dykal Stadium to take on 4-1 South Dakota State. Kickoff at 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. Midco Sports will have it. Special pregame from them starting at 1:30. You can also see it on ESPN Plus or our Jackrabbits All Access subscription service. And don't forget, we'll have a 2-hour pregame throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network. Brent Bowen, Scotty Quaz, Alex Parker, and myself will be on hand. This rivalry dates back to the year that this state became a state, 1889, and the rivalry is renewed tomorrow afternoon, 2 o'clock at Dana J. Dykal Stadium, as second-ranked SDSU welcomes in the Coyotes of South Dakota.